Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about RabbitMQ, and we're going to create a new Docker image based on the official RabbitMQ Docker image, and we're going to place our own configuration file inside it. We're going to add a definitions file so we can actually define queues, exchanges, we can bind these together with the definition.conf or .json file, and we're going to add our own rabbitmq.conf file, because that means that then we have our own image with our own configuration, then we don't need to set it up manually through the UI every time we set up a new RabbitMQ instance. So just to summarize, we need to create a rabbitmq.conf file, we need to create a definitions.json file. I'm going to use the official Docker image, which has the management enabled. So we have the official RabbitMQ with management with the management plugin enable. Then we're going to create a Docker image with this Docker image, and this is made from the Docker file. So we have the Docker image right here, Docker. So the first thing we're going to create is actually the Docker file. So we create the Docker file. In the same directory, we create the rabbitmq.conf file, we create a definitions.json file. Inside the Docker file, we will actually say that we actually need to inject or to add these into our image, these two files right here. We will use the copy command to do that. And yeah, that's actually it. So the difficult part is actually to create this definition file and this file right here, and then we'll use Docker Compose after that to actually start up a container based on the new image that we created right there. So it means we have Docker Compose as the .yml, Docker Compose .yml. It looks like an X, this is why. And we use that to start up a container based on that image right there. So that is the plan, that is the idea. Let us get right into it as usual. I have a project right here. I'm going to create a new folder, which we can name custom Docker image. Sounds like a good name. In here, I'm going to create the Docker Compose file, docker-compose.yml. That's the one that should start up, that will start up our image. Then I'm going to create a Docker file, which will create our image, actually Docker file. Add, then we need the rabbitmq.conf file, rabbitmq.conf file. And of course, all the stuff that I'm adding to this rabbitmq.conf file, they are documented at rabbitmq's page, at the homepage right here. Here's rabbitmq/configure.html. So there's a lot of good configuration readup stuff right here. We are using only a few of the keys and of the features. And then there's another file that we need to set, another piece of documentation we need to read. That's the management HTML, because we can actually place something called the management.load properties. We're going to set this property right here, which is described in them, and that's because we have the management plugin enabled. So we are adding this management.load_definitions and then path to the definitions that we are creating. But let us get right into it. We have the rabbitmq file, right, the conf file right there. Then I want to add a new file. This is my definitions.json file, which is right here. Add it to Git. Thank you very much, IntelliJ. So that's actually files. That's the files that I need. Then I need to add from. We're not in the Docker file. Let me just cut that. The Docker file is right here, from. And then we are from the official RabbitMQ image. And the tag is 3-management. We need the management enabled for this experiment right here. And then I want to copy the definitions.json into etc rabbitmq, and then that's actually it. We just want to add it there, definitions.json. and then I want to copy. Remember, we always use copy unless we should never use add unless we are actually unless we have a tarball that we want to be have extracted inside our Docker image. Then we have our. Let me just find this. Then we have the rabbitmq.conf file right here. We copy that to rabbitmq.conf right there, and then I'll add in my Docker Compose file. Then I will set an environment that actually tells rabbitmq where this file is located. That's actually it. That's actually how small our rabbitmq Docker file actually needs to be. Then I need to go to my rabbitmq.conf file, and then we need to set this one up. And I've prepared a little bit. Let me see if I can find it. Of course I can. I'm going to copy something here, right here. And this part down here, that is only because This is because we have the management plugin enabled, so that means that then we actually can use this management.load definitions part right here, and then we can give a location. That means etc rabbitmq, and then we'll say definitions.json. Then this will be loaded on startup. We're not using SSL, we're using default port for management and default port for rabbitmq in general. That is actually it. Yes, that's it. Then we have the definition file. Let us build this one up because this is a little bit more complex. Of course, it needs to, as a standard, we need to follow, of course. It is a JSON, so it's actually, you can also create it from an export, actually. Then we have users, that's the first part right here. And then we have, that is an array of users. And then we have an object right here, and then we have a name. The name in a situation, it could be guest, that is the default name that we have actually. It has a password, guest, and then we give it some tags. If we apply the tag administrator, then we can log into the UI, then we can log into the management UI. If not, then we can't. So I'm going to create another user because we're actually not going to use the guest user. We're going to use the Mike user. Mike right here. Password Mike. And then should we give it something else? Mike twice. So then we have Mike twice, and I'm going to apply the tag administrator because then I can actually log in. So this is the users. So that's actually enough for the users. Then we need to define something called vhosts, and that is an array. And we're just going to create one object right here, and we're going to give it the name slash. So we're not, So that is the virtual host. And then we have some permissions, because now we need to give Mike the permission to do stuff, and also the, I'm going to say a user, guest, if I could spell it correctly, that's right there. Then we can see, say, which hosts should this user be allowed to use. And I'll just write slash, and then I say configure, and then we can actually use wildcards to what we're allowed to configure. In our case, I just want to allow us to configure everything. And then we have write. What should we be able to write to? Everything again. Just using a wildcard. And then we have read. That is also wildcards right there. So let me just copy this whole section right there, because we also need to set up Mike. What should Mike be allowed to do? And that should actually be the same. So here we have Mike. Then we have something called parameters right there. parameters like this. How come it didn't, it should have looked, oh, okay, it should be inside the, let me just check here. That is because I added the parameters in the wrong place, so I'll just add it right there. Parameters, and that's an array of, yeah, some parameters, right? We don't need any right now. Policies, we don't need any of those. That's also an array. And then we have something called exchanges. This is important. I want to define some exchanges. And that's also an array. And here we have an object, and I want to have an exchange called named Mike's exchange. Or let us call something else, because I don't want this name to be the same as I've used in the other examples. So we have an alien exchange. So that means that aliens can receive mail in this scenario right here. Alien exchange. Alien, we can make dots. It's actually normal to use dots when naming queues and exchanges in RabbitMQ. So let us just use a dot, alien dot exchange. And then we have need to define which vhost this is applied to. That is the default. Type, I'll just choose fan out. Of course, you can also have the topic or whatever you want. Durable. Let's set this to true. Durable, that means that there should be, when we restart the RabbitMQ, do we want the messages still to be located there, though the messages that was not picked up? And yeah, in our situation, yes, we want that. Auto delete, no, do not auto delete, only delete when they're picked up, and the receiver says that they should be relieved, deleted. False, that's not an internal queue, it's my queue. Oh, sorry, it's my exchange, so it's not an internal exchange. Arguments, no arguments. So this is actually my exchange. Let us just stop there. So that is our exchange. It's just one exchange. That's fine. Then the next part is quite interesting also. That is the queues. Of course, that's actually what we usually want to set up. And it's also objects. And we have a name right here. And this could be alien.queue. Ferry, that's all the ferry aliens, or just ferry. We know it's a queue, so alien, ferry, and then the interqueue vhost again. And it's slash again. And durable. We can set this to true. We can have auto delete, and it's false. And then we have arguments. In arguments, we can actually set something like the dead letter Q or stuff like that if you want to. Right now, I want to have a simple example right here, so I'm just leaving this blank empty. So that was one Q. Let us create another Q. Alien furry. Alien, maybe for the tall aliens, we can get this Q right here. Let's create a new Q again. This is then for the, this could be for the chubby aliens. Yeah, that's it. And then the next important thing we need to do is the bindings, because now we need to bind the exchange to the queue. So I'll write bindings, colon, and then that's auto array, surprise, and it's an object. And in this situation, I need to give a source, and the source, that is the name of the exchange, which I've already forgotten, of course, alien.exchange. Ah, okay. I should have remembered that. So then I go down here, alien exchange, like this. And it has a source, it has a vhost. Of course, you're not supposed to remember that. I cannot remember this either. I'm actually looking at another screen. Well, I have an example that I just set up just before. Destination, and then I can actually set the destination, and in my situation it's alien dot maybe the alien.furry. So that means that then the furry queue will actually receive these messages right here. And the routing key does not matter in this situation right here. Routing key. We could set a routing key. I'll just set this to alien.furry. And then I'll use the pound key or the hashtag, and that is because that is a wildcard. So that means that the routing key needs to contain something with the alien.furry. Something. Then I'm going to create a new binding for the next queue. Control C, Control V, and also the third one. Just create all three or three. Here we have the destination that's alien, that's tall. The routing key is tall. The destination is chubby. And routing key chubby right here. And let me check if I forgot some things. That was the bindings, and that was actually it. So the bindings were actually the last thing we needed. It looks good on file, there's no red markings, so at least the JSON is valid. It looks valid. If we made any huge mistakes, we'll only know after starting up RabbitMQ, of course. Let me just turn off something right here. So, there was just a refrigerator next to me, and I wanted to turn off. So, that was the definitions, and then we have the RabbitMQ file, we have the Docker file, RabbitMQ, definitions. Then we have the Docker Compose file we need to fill out, and here we need to give something called services, or service. Need to give a version also. So on our Docker Compose file right here, we need to say version, and we can use 3.7, which is the current one. So the Docker Compose, and then we have some services in our Docker Compose file. We have Mike's RabbitMQ service, and in here we need to build this, and this is built by. Building from the Docker file, which is located in the same directory. That's why we choose this dot right here. And what is the next thing? We have some. We don't need to give any volumes. We don't need to create networks. We need to create environment. That is pretty. We also need to have some ports mapped out. Let's start with environment. Environment like this. We need to give the. We need to give the rabbit. I'll just copy it. It's easier. So we need to copy the. I need to have the. We need to tell which configuration file to use. RabbitMQ config file, which should just be rabbitmq.conf, like this. And. And then we have the. Then there's some extra information. We will allow like some log, or like some debug log when we're running. So that means that then I'll add this server additional arguments, and then we add the log console. And I'll actually set this to debug actually. Right here. Environment, then we need to set some ports. Ports, colon. And then we set 15.672, and that should be mapped to the same port 15.672, like this. And I would also like to have the other port mapped. So the one was the management. This is the management port, this one, and the other one, that is the default RabbitMQ if you want to send or receive messages to the exchange or receive messages on the queues. So that's actually it. Another thing, I made a demo the other night, so let me just clear this in my Docker PS. Docker im-f, and I want to force stop this one, because I was playing around with Docker before, so I want to stop the other containers that are running. So we only have, so we don't have Datadog, we don't have RabbitMQ running, copy. Docker im-f for force. Docker PS, let's just check. Okay, so now we don't have any images, any containers running. Let us try the Docker Compose file and see how many errors I made, how many mistakes I made. So we are building Mike's RabbitMQ from management. Yes, thank you very much. Copying the definitions in there, definitions.json and the conf was deployed successfully. It actually means that it is running without any errors. That's incredible. It's actually running there. Okay, then I try to start a browser. I'm always surprised when it works without tweaking afterwards. So let's just go to localhost colon 15672, like this. Enter. There's no template. Okay, so there was an error. Docker logs. Then we check the log from our container. Copy, paste. Let's see what it says. Alien furry, blah blah blah, undefined. There are some errors in the. It doesn't like my definitions file, so it actually stops crash report, blah blah blah. Run into list, blah 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 blah. At line 100, blah blah blah. Let us check the definitions. I made a mistake in definitions, I'm pretty sure. So let me just go check. Definitions right here. Users, guest administrator. We finished this one right here. Here we have the alien exchange. Destination. Alien furry, that's actually the first one it complains at, wasn't that so? Let me just check here. Bindings, source, destination, routing key. It looks okay actually, but of course there's some error right there. And I found the error. Let me just show in the definitions.json file, I wrote permission without an S in end. And I forgot to add something called arguments on the queues, I think it was, or maybe now it was on the bindings. There should also be some arguments there. And I just left them out empty. Another thing is the routing key doesn't matter because I've chosen the fan out. The exchange has the type fan out. I also forgot something called destination type on the binding, actually. On the binding itself, it needs to have a destination type. Do we want to bind this exchange to send messages to another exchange, or should it be sent to another queue? So that means that this name right here, does it point to a queue or does it point to an exchange? We need to set that right here. I would actually recommend that you actually set up what you need to set up in your in one instance of RabbitMQ through the UI, and then do an export instead of sitting and try to create all this by hand as I'm doing right here. Of course it is possible, but it will take you a little bit longer and you might make some mistakes just like I did there. So create your configuration through the UI, then export instead. But nevertheless, I rebuilt the image. First I had to delete the image, or else I would not put in the new definitions.json file that I created, and then I rebuilt after removing the old images with the. I actually had to go into my console, to be honest, and then I had to write Docker images, and I had to look for the images, and I had to delete them by hand, the custom Docker image here, or else I could not get the new definitions.json inside the image. It would not detect that it was different, and then it actually did not build, and it just went to the latest image tag. But enough about that. That's Docker specific. I actually want to show you that with this configuration that I've set up now, with this Docker file that I have here right here, where I copy the RabbitMQ configuration and the definitions.json file into my RabbitMQ Docker image. Then by starting that up with this environment variable right here that actually says that we should use the configuration file located right there, then we can get our own custom RabbitMQ that has some queues and it has some exchanges, and it has some bindings. So let me just go show that now. I just started up the container through Docker Compose. 672 is right there. That is. And yeah, it remembered my login from last time. I would like to log out because I would like to use the. I'd like to see the with like yeah. You look now right now I'm user guest. I would like to log in with the mic user. So I'll write mic, and I'll just zoom in so you can see it a bit better. Mic, and then the password was mic, and then I log in with the new user that will be defined, and it actually works. So no, I do not want to save the name to Dashlane. It was just it's just for demonstration purposes. It actually works, and you can see here on the admin tab, then we actually have one user called guest, one user called Mike, and they both have the tag called administrator. So I'm actually, as usual, very proud of myself. And if I press the Q tab, then I can see here I have the three Qs, Alien Tall, Chubby Furry. They all have one message inside them because I just made a small test after I messed up a bit in the first time. Then I created a small test before I started the recording again. And then I have my exchange right here. My Alien Exchange, it's right there. Very, very cool. And there's actually a rate. There's some metrics right there, and it uses the fan out as we said. And let's go test it. Let's go try it out. So we can actually see here's the bindings. If we press it, here we have the bindings. Chubby, the alien furry, the alien tall, have all those three bindings right there. Let me try to send a test message. It actually does not matter what I type into the routing queue as the routing key, because the exchange has the type fan out. That means it just spreads out to all the queues that is bound to this exchange. And then I will say something like, have a nice evening, all aliens. I had it, I fixed the errors in definitions.json, so now I'm happy. Again, smiley. So let me just go up here, cancel I. That's it. So just to have a message, and then I publish this message right here now. Message has been published. Then I can go back to my queues, and now we have two messages in each queue. Let me just go to a random one, furry, alien furry. I can click on this one. We can see some statistics. We have two of the messages are ready to be picked up. Okay, let me go pick up my message. I'll just go back to 100% zoom again. I'll go say get the message. Do not requeue it. Just delete it afterwards. Get my message. Then I get the first message. I'll zooming in again now a bit here. Here we have the exchange was alien exchange. The routing key was something. It doesn't matter. Here we have the payload. The payload, and that's the first test that I made before starting the recording again, and that was just some random characters. Then let me get another message. Now I got the next message, and here we have the greeting message that we just made together. Have a nice evening, all aliens. I fixed the errors and definitions, and so now I'm happy again. So cool. Let me try to get message again. The queue is empty. There are no more messages. This is really, really cool. Just for fun, let us just pick. We see here now we have Alien Fairy, there's zero messages there. Then let me go to Tall, and then let me get the messages also there. And I do not want to requeue them. No, get one message. I get the same weird message with the payload where I just type something in on the keyboard. I'll get another message, and here again, I got my greetings right now. I am so happy. It was a huge success after I fixed the initial problems in the definitions.json file. That is actually it. One thing. Yeah, that's actually it. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. Have a great evening. I hope to see you again very, very soon. Bye-bye.